Ms. Rand, in your novels, you portray very strong women. I was wondering why you think in the world we don't have strong women leaders.
Because if you're speaking about women's liberation, that whole movement, it's a very false and phony issue. Women are human beings, so they need leaders just like men in certain professions. If in their own profession, they don't need leaders. But let's say in politics, they need leaders who are men or women as the leaders have earned. There is no such thing as specifically a leader of women. But just as it would be ridiculous to say you have leaders of only men.
Well, but the point is that women feel, because of the cultural inhibitors that have been placed on women, some sort of woman leadership is needed to compensate and to break those barriers and to make good all the grievances of the past.
You can do it only by education. If women feel that there is prejudice against them,
yes,
you do it by spreading the right idea that women intellectually are not the inferior of men.
Of course not, but
physically they certainly
that's
are.
That's what feminists are doing. They're standing up and educating.
No, they're asking for government power and government handouts. They go around depriving men of jobs because you have to have quota of so many women.
But their point is that they have been denied jobs all these years. So let's get at it and start swinging for it.
You do not fight an evil if they think they're victims. I don't. But let us say, assuming that women have been treated unfairly, you don't fight an evil by adopting it and practicing
it. Well, what should they do? Be nice little girls and not say anything and stay home and break bread?
No.
Well, what should they do?
Go into any career of their choice except longshoreman or professional football player, as they're trying today, and fight for their career as every man has to fight.
Would you fight for anything?
How did I get here?
Yeah, nigga, I'm still fucking with you. Still waters run deep. Still Snoop Dogg and D.R.